In this video, I'm going to show you how to go ahead and stream to YouTube utilizing OBS Studio. Let's go ahead and dive in. So the very first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go ahead and open up OBS Studio. If you don't have OBS Studio installed, I'll put a link in the description of this video for you to go ahead and get it all set up. So once you have OBS Studio open, you're going to come here to the right-hand side and we're going to select settings. The first thing we're going to do is going to get connected to YouTube. So you're going to come on the left, you're going to select stream. When it says service, you're going to click that and you're going to select YouTube RTMPS. Now you're going to have two options here. It's going to say connect account, which is the recommended and is the one I recommend as well. And then use your stream key. Now, before we go ahead and connect our account to YouTube, there's one important thing that you need to know. If you've never streamed to YouTube, you are going to need to go ahead and get approved. And it does take 24 hours for you to go ahead and gain access. The amount of subscribers and viewers and things that you have does not matter. You just need to get approved and request access, and it does take 24 hours. So let me go ahead and show you what that looks like if it's going to be your first time trying to stream on YouTube. So once you get logged into your YouTube channel, you're going to come to the top right and you're going to go ahead and select go live. Once you go ahead and select that, it's going to bring you to a screen just like this. It's going to say request access to streaming. Once requested, it may take up 24 hours to gain access to live streaming. So you simply go ahead and select request. It's going to give you a timer and then you'll be able to check back in within 24 hours. So once you've gone ahead and gotten approved, you can go ahead and continue to follow along with the steps that I'm about to show you now. So we'll come back here to OBS and now we can go ahead and select connect account. Once we do that, that's going to go ahead and ask us to go ahead and get logged in with our YouTube channel. We'll then go ahead and say continue to give access to OBS. And then it's going to say authorization completed successfully. You can now close this page. So I'm going to come back here to OBS and you're going to see here that now my account has been connected. Then you want to make sure you select here where it says ignore streaming service settings recommendations. You want to make sure that that is unchecked. Then you're going to go ahead and press OK. This is going to go ahead and pop up a window just like this. Now, because OBS integrates to YouTube, you're going to be able to monitor your YouTube chat directly inside of OBS. So you can see here, YouTube chat, once a broadcast has been created, your live stream chat would appear here, right? So we'll go ahead and scroll this over. We'll go ahead and tag this here to the left. So just drag it until you see it pop up. And now it's going to go ahead and be in place. So now that we have that in place, now we want to go ahead and set up our live stream to be able to make sure that when it goes live. So you'll come here to the right and you're going to select manage broadcast. This is the benefit of connecting using the recommended option because you can customize everything directly inside of OBS. So you're going to go ahead and select create a new broadcast. You're going to name this your title of your stream. Make sure you utilize something that generates some curiosity, gets people interested on what you're going to be talking about. Your description, this is where you're going to be able to put in links to follow you on social media, to be able to donate. This is where you put in the information about what your stream's about and what where people can find you. Now here where it says privacy, this is extremely important because if you have this on private or unlisted, that means that when you go live, no one's going to be able to see your stream. So you want to make sure you have this on public. Then you want to do your category. You want to go ahead and put gaming. You want to go ahead and put no, this is not for kids. And then you want to go ahead and put in your thumbnail. You can go ahead and upload your custom thumbnail, which I recommend. And then as far as latency, I recommend leaving it at normal. That's going to give you the best quality. So then you can go ahead now. And when you do that, when you have it on public, you can go ahead and say create broadcast. Now, I don't recommend creating broadcast and start streaming because you want to be able to set up your settings to make it look good. So I'm going to select create broadcast. It's going to say creating a new live broadcast. Please wait. You're going to see here that now on the left hand side, my chat is now available. So we want to jump over to YouTube to make sure that broadcast was created. Now, remember, we're not live yet. So we'll come back here to YouTube to make sure that we're all ready to go. So on your YouTube channel, you're going to come to your profile icon. You're going to go ahead and select YouTube Studio. And then on the left-hand side, you're going to select content. Then you're going to come to the top. You're going to select live and you're going to see your broadcast here. What you want to select is this little icon here that says view in live control room. So once you click that, you're going to be able to see here that now our live has been created. We're not live yet, but it has been created for us. It's going to have our title, our description, everything is ready to go. So once you've done that, we now need to come back into OBS Studio. So just connecting your YouTube channel to OBS Studio is not everything you need to do. Now we need to make sure that your settings are correct so that way your stream looks good. You don't want your stream to be laggy or to be choppy. You want to give your viewers a good experience. So let's go ahead and get our settings set up so that way your stream looks good. So let's go ahead and jump into OBS. All right, so inside of OBS Studio, you're going to come to where it says settings. We're then going to go ahead and first we're going to double check our video. So on YouTube, you can go ahead and stream higher than 1080p quality. But for this example, I'm going to use 1080p since most people are going to watch your stream on mobile and that's all you really need. So you want to make sure you have 1920 by 1080, 1920 by 1080, and then your FPS, you want to have it at 60. This is what I recommend, but again, it's all going to be based on your computer and your internet speed. So if you do need to go ahead and lower this, you can go ahead and drop this to 30 to be able to make sure your quality looks good. So once you have that in place, we're going to come to where it says output. These are going to be the settings that are going to be super important to make sure that your stream looks good. So you can come up top to output mode and select advance. And then here for your encoder, you're going to have several options based on what you're utilizing. So typically you can use X264 or you can go ahead and use your graphic card if you are on a Windows. And if you are on a Mac, you're going to want to use your hardware encoder. So then we're going to come down here where it says rate control CBR. This is going to be the most important aspect of streaming. Your bit rate is going to determine how well your stream is going to look. And to be able to find out what bit rate you can utilize, this is all based on your internet speed. So I'm going to show you now how to go ahead and check your internet speed so you know what kind of bit rate you can put so that way your stream looks good. So let's go ahead and jump back into the computer. So you're going to want to come to a website called speedtest.net, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. You're going to want to hit go, and then once you hit go, that's going to generate a number just like this. It's going to generate your download speed and your upload. The number that we care about is going to be your upload speed. This is what we're going to utilize to determine our bit rate. Now, if you come to the link in the description where I put a link telling you what bit rate to utilize based on the quality that you want, this is provided by YouTube. So again, I mentioned we're going to do a 1080p 60 frames per second kind of stream. So if we click that, it's going to tell us that our video bit range needs to be between 4500 and 9000. So to be able to understand what this number is, I just look at the first number, 4 and 9. So what you want to do is you want to at least have a 20 upload if you're going to go 9000, and if you're going to go 4500, you want to have at least a 10 upload. So that's going to be this number here. So I have 500, right? And I only need 20 to be able to go ahead and do 1080p 60 frames per second at the highest number that YouTube recommends. Rule of thumb that I recommend is that whatever your upload speed is, cut that in half, and that's going to be the amount of bitrate you can utilize. So for me, it's 500. I can say 250. So 250,000 is what I have available, which is overkill for what YouTube is recommending. So now that we have that number there, and if you can't do 1080p because your internet speed, you can come here and do 720p 60. And you can see here that's going to allow you to go as low as 2,250, meaning you can just have a 5 upload, right? So this article is going to be available for you in the description of this video. So now that we know that bit rate, we're going to come back here, right? So I know that I can go ahead and put 9,000 because my internet can support it. So once you have that bit rate, you input that there. Your keyframe interval, you're going to put it at 2 seconds, and your profile, you're going to put it at high. You're going to go ahead and select OK. So now that we have our settings correct, what we're going to want to do now is, now that we have everything ready, we're going to go ahead and hit start streaming. And so that's going to say start streaming. You can see here that now we're live. So what we want to do is we want to go ahead and jump back over to YouTube to confirm that we're now sending over our stream. So you see here that now we are live. Everything is ready to go. Excellent condition. You're going to see here that I can monitor my chat, and now everything is ready to go and I can start to go live with my audience. Now inside of OBS Studio, you're going to be able to manage your chat here on the left hand side. But if you want to go ahead and have overlays and graphics to make your stream look professional, you want to go to streamdesigns.com, and I'll put a link in the description of this video where you can get overlays for your stream. And the package that I'm using here today is going to be called Shadow, that you can go ahead and find on Stream Designs along with other packages. So this is going to be the Shadow package, and that's going to go ahead and include everything that I need to make my stream look professional. So you can see here that I'm going to go ahead and have my overlay screens, my panels, my alerts, everything that I need to make my stream look professional. So you can go to streamdesigns.com to be able to get overlays. And then once you go ahead and have your overlays to be able to know how to go ahead and get them all set up, go ahead and watch this video where I walk you step by step on how to set up overlays inside of OBS Studio to make your stream look professional. I'll see you guys in the next video.